there! Today, I'll be giving you a special tutorial about how to master the famous cross-eyed viewing method and show you what your eyes will see if you do it correctly. I'll also show you how to make free cross-eyed 3D glasses, take 3D photos, and calculate your optimal cross-eyed 3D viewing distance. Okay, let's get started! Let me bring up a stereogram image you took earlier. Stereograms are basically two left and right views joined together, with one image for each eye. For cross-eye viewing, the images are swapped horizontally. When viewing 3D stereograms, position yourself in front of the image, right at the center, and keep your eyes horizontal to it. You should avoid tilting your head or viewing the image from an odd angle. Now, I will cross my eyes as though I am looking at something close to my face. Let me demonstrate this with my index finger. Notice that as I look at my finger moving closer to my face, my left and right line of vision start to cross each other. This is where the cross-eyed method gets its name from. Now, if I do this while the two stereo images are in the background, I will encounter double vision as shown. The objective of the cross-eyed method is to refocus the eye so the two innermost images merge into one at the center. If you are successful, the center image will appear in 3D. But wait, there's more! Before you try this out, there are two extra things you can do to improve your chances of success. The first is to calculate the perfect spot to put your eyes. To do this, you will need to find the width of the stereogram, the distance between the center of your eyes, and the shortest distance you can comfortably read a book. Then, enter the numbers into this formula, and it should tell you how far your eyes should be from the stereogram to view it comfortably. Basically, put your eyes here and look here, and both images in the back will merge into 3D automatically. Don't worry, if you use full screen all the time, you only need to do this once because the images will have the same measurements. The next thing you can do to perfect your 3D viewing experience is to block the extra images at the side from appearing when you cross your eyes. To do this, start by viewing the image in 3D using the cross-eyed method. Then, raise both hands up 10 centimeters in front of your face at each side, just like this, and slowly bring them together towards the center of your eyes as shown. Doing this causes your hands to block the right image from your right eye and the left image from your left eye. This leaves you with a single 3D image at the center. Once you have found the right spot, simply hold your hands in that position. Once you understand how this works, you can create your own 3D glasses for viewing cross-eyed 3D images. Just take two small black pieces of paper as shown, fold the ends into a hook, and hang or stick them over a pair of glasses. Make adjustments by sliding the sheets of paper left and right to obtain the same blocking effect as your hands. Now that I've shown you the basics of cross-eyed viewing, I'll show you how to take some simple 3D photos and videos. All you need to do is capture two images, one for each of your eyes. If you don't have a 3D lens or a 3D camera, you can still do this using one or two normal cameras. If you have two identical cameras, put them side by side and capture both images at the same time. If you only have one camera, keep the subject perfectly still and quickly move the camera to take two separate photos for each eye. For the best results, try to use the same camera settings for both images and keep them both on the same level as each other. Once you are done, join them together side by side on your computer and save the image file. Remember to keep the original so you can modify and import them into other 3D viewing systems. Even if you don't have a 3D display now, taking 3D photos is still important, as it might be too late to go back in time to capture precious moments in 3D. The concept behind 3D has remained the same for millennia, so all your 3D photos taken today can be easily imported into the 3D systems of the future. For example, this 3D photo taken in 1860 is still viewable even today. There are also many other methods used to view 3D, but if you are unable to access them, then this cross-eyed method is one of the best free alternatives available and should work just fine without any equipment at all. Well, that about covers the basics of cross-eyed viewing, and we've come to the end of this video. I hope you'll find the cross-eyed method useful. Good luck, and have fun with 3D. Thanks for watching! I wonder what we should do on our next video. This sunset is really pretty. We should do a film here in the evening. The water here is pretty shallow. I guess it should be alright to film here. Now, all we have to do is decide what to film next. Water sports? Nah, too hard. But I want to go swimming. You didn't pack any swimwear. Oh well, there's always next time.